We are arresting. We are charging. We are investigating all bad actors.
Hi there, everyone. Dan Dix here for Press for Truth, reporting live in downtown Ottawa. It's around 9 a.m. or so, and the police have just started pushing forward on the protest. It's moving rather quickly. I'm about a minute away or so, so I want to get the stream going. Guys, please share this one. Get this one out there, guys. It's all going down right now. What you're hearing in the news is that yesterday 100 people were arrested. That's true, and it isn't. All the arrests were fake. They were for show, essentially. I've already interviewed and spoken with a number of people who have told me they were arrested and let go a few hours later with no charges and no actual arrest on record. So, essentially that just means they've been using the emergency act to pull off these arrests, even though it's currently still being debated. Watching, only 57 thumbs up. That doesn't add up. Come on, my friends, click that like button, share this stream. All the action is going down right now, right around the corner. It looks like they're moving in on the final remaining protesters and the few trucks that remain. It was just yesterday, last night, I witnessed police convincing, literally convincing truckers to leave, and some of them did. And of course, many of them are holding the line strong. Oh, this reminds me of my days of chasing around Bilderbergers. A bunch of gear on the back. But this is perhaps one of the most important moments in Canada's history when it comes to protesting and fighting for freedoms. Thanks for clicking the like button, guys. Don't forget to share the stream for me. Follow me on Twitter for more live stuff too. I'm going to be live tweeting the whole time. As best I can. Can you see my words? Yes, I can. Sorry, guys, it's hard to monitor the chat while it's difficult to walk out here. Very slippery and snow everywhere. That's right, not only Canada, world history. This movement, revolution, if you will, has sparked a freedom movement all around the world. This is why I spent the last 6 days driving out to Ottawa to cover this historic moment. And we're coming up to Parliament right now. These are where the last few remaining truckers are. strong. But the police are moving in on them right now. So we're almost there. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Get this one going. I'm gonna stay live for as long as I can. Probably, I don't know, 3 or 4 hours. Been having some problems with my phone charging, so we'll see how that goes. But I got backups too. So, but we're just walking into the thick of it now, as I said, where the remaining truckers are. And a couple dozen protesters were just forcefully shoved out of the way. So somebody says arrest, more like catch and release. Exactly. That's precisely what's happening here. I've already spoken to 2 separate people who told me they were arrested, driven down the street, held for a couple hours, and then let go. No charges, no arrests on record. Because of the police activity, I'm sure. You ever notice how the news is constantly saying so-called freedom convoy? Nothing about this. It's been all about freedom, peace, love, save for a few provocateurs who rather successfully gave the media a perfect excuse to label everyone as some sort of violent white supremacist, which, from what I can see on the ground here, is the furthest thing from the truth. Again, if you're just tuning in, guys, police are clamping down on the truckers now. They've just pushed back on a number of protesters. It's all happening about 100 feet in front of me. Police have pushed their line all the way up to the remaining trucks. That truck revving his engine. They got the police line, big L red tank, everything right here. Fox News is here. This is as close as we're getting here. Thank you. gotta make sure I can back up quickly this time. Last time they cracked me ribs. I got a lot of these guys who stare right at me. And then some of them earlier were just talking about me and pointing me out. And then I heard... And then I heard that they were targeting some people with some larger streams. So I need to stay a little bit back this time. Just, I don't want them to snag me.
The hawking will continue until freedom is free!
We're not afraid, you guys! Okay, my phone is charging good right now because I'm not moving a lot, so I'm just going to stay here and let this charge because this is just going to continue to rev up. As we said, they've just brought in all the guys with the gas masks. So it looks like they may be getting ready to deploy tear gas on this totally peaceful crowd.
Keep going with you, what you're doing. I'm watching you all die.
So if you're just tuning in, guys, they pushed this crowd back all the way from another street, multiple blocks, and then eventually kettled everybody onto this small street. And now they're reinforcing the police with the riot cops, and they have the tear gas masks on. So it looks like they're going to escalate this another level.
The world.
So that's the riot police service that's here. And they're mobilizing to go to another area, it looks like.
Not when I'm trying to get arrested. I'm going grocery shopping. You can't see my lips, but I have a mask on. And they're going to arrest me for my 3-year-old. Because I can't talk to her without my face mask. How is that okay?
What if she doesn't want? What about freedom of choice?
The freedom of choice.
It doesn't matter what they get, it's a choice, it's freedom. Is this what you want your legacy to be? You guys really want your kids to know that you are on the opposite side?
I don't know what
he's doing. He's not really doing anything. He's Trudeau's puppet. Because unfortunately, he's here. Is getting the vaccine a choice? Is getting the vaccine a choice? It is a choice. So if you choose not to, you lose your job. Is it a choice for you?
I think so. This is one of the steps.
If you're not here, you're going to lose your job. I agree, but my point is that we want our freedom back, because a choice between losing your job or getting the vaccine is not a choice. Do you have the choice to quit and go home? It doesn't seem that way because we're being pushed away.
The cop said citizens of Ottawa also have freedom. That's why they're pushing people away. He said, this is your right to speak your mind. Please feel freely to do so. That's what he said. He just said, there's nothing I can do with the vaccine mandate. I'm not been forced on the vaccine mandate, he said. She said, because you're standing here, you are enforcing it. So she's explaining that her 3-year-old can't hear her talk. I'm kind of surprised this cop's engaging with people they usually don't talk to.
You know how effective they are.
He said, I understand the research you believe in. You can believe whatever you want to believe. He said.
It's a matter of science that's trying to prove versus a guy in a white coat. Can you say, I'm a winner? What is the proof? I'm a white coat. Zero. 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 Neither am I, but I've seen a lot of information to make we believe that it's not.
You just keep saying you're free to express yourself.
Well, the information absolutely. Ryerson University did a study.
I'm sorry about yourself. just love talking about ice cream, and you can tell you this is my
mom. That's what that is, Howard. You got to have it. If you drop your helmet, they did it in France, 2021, July. The French police, they drop their helmet,
and they call me Chief Peter Sloly. That's how you guys do that. You guys are all right, I'm going to say, you guys do that. What do you guys want freedom like us? You want more freedom too, your grandkids.
Thank you so much, Robert, for the contribution. Your donation is really greatly appreciated. Again, dan@pressfortruth.ca if anybody wants to send one type of donation. Or you could go to pressfortruth.ca/donate. There's options there. Bitcoin, other cryptocurrencies, PayPal, Subscribestar.
Oh, okay. That double pair of pants. And a beard.
Thank you, Bradford, for the donation. Just got the notification. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Come on, man.
There you go.
My brother.
Tell them to stand down. We're peaceful, you know that. They trampled an elderly lady who barely escaped by the skin of her teeth. She has been there from the beginning. They trampled over her, and it's not a good look. They don't need the horses. We just want dialogue and somebody in there to talk to the people. I know, but look, it's not safe. There's elderly people and children. It's not right, man. This is not democracy that you do all that. This is what you see on the news in the third world.
So you're just tuning in, guys. Police have formed the lines, multiple police lines all the way around Parliament, blocking people from the truckers.
There's a sick officer in your battalion. And I know you just came from
Canolatardistani. And I think now that they have the protesters separated from the truckers, they're
going to
move in and start working on the
truck. Yeah, he loves the extra paper. Just stacked up.
So the trucks are all way back there.
In the wall, wherever they can. Wherever they can. They won't stop.
And they're going to put anybody over there.
And
we've been on the front lines all day, taking quite a beating. Thank you so much, Scott, for your contribution. Very, very greatly appreciated. Guys, I plan on being out here for as long as it takes. How long have you been on the force in Toronto? So were you there during the 2020 event? Yeah, what did you think of that event?
I remember when they enacted the Public Works Protection Act, that allowed the police orders to be able to check people's IDs and defense and things like that. I don't know if you know, 10 years later, a civil lawsuit came. $16.5 million was awarded to all those protesters who were kettled and arrested. And it was proven that justice eventually was won and all those people got a settlement. And we're seeing very similar things here today in Ottawa. I made a documentary film about it. If you want to check it out, it's called Into the Fire. Yeah, I documented the entire event chronologically throughout that weekend.
Please check it out. Probably one of the videos I'm most proud of out of my 16 years at PressForTruth. 17.
that with them skewers.
Well, somebody just commented boring.
Yeah,
go back in my stream a little bit. And sometimes that's what it's like when you have to wait out for the action. If I'm not here, I'm not going to capture it. So yeah, there are downtimes.
Yeah!
Well, Toronto cops are pretty good. Toronto cops are pretty good. Those green guys are nice. They got like sticks, no, you fuck. These guys are man, this is gonna be such an episode. I was you, I was like, quickly, jump to Nuremberg, I'm gonna be Nuremberg 2, Corona Investigating Committee, Grand Jury Day 1, February 5th, 2022, Public Grand Jury Day 1, Opening Statement.
Switching out, please.
The PCR test.
Leaving some, putting in some new ones.
No, I have not the biggest social media following.
Chad is asking, have I seen the green riot cops? With no name tags, yes. That is the Sûreté du Québec police. And a lot of them have no name tags, no badge numbers, no identification whatsoever. They're just essentially anonymous police.
New Zealand, Australia, Canada, UK, and the United States are the fifth eyes of paper towards right.
Somebody asked, will I be making a compilation video of the most riveting moments? I'm going to be a little too busy here to do that kind of editing. So, not likely. Because I'm just a one-man show. I do all the filming and the editing and the uploading and the promoting and the, you know, the thumbnail, write the description, come up with the title, all that jazz. So I'm a little busy out here filming the front lines to be sitting in the hotel editing. But I would love to see one. Maybe somebody else up there will do it. This landmass has nothing to do with me. I'm pretty disgusted by this country right now. Can't even get on an airplane. I had to drive 6 days to get here. All because of my medical vaccine.